Christ, the bars of your gates, he blesses your children within you. He makes peace in your borders, he fills you with the finest of meat. He sends out his command to the earth, his word runs swiftly. He gives snow like wool, he scatters frost like ashes. He hurls down his crystals of ice like crumbs. Who can stand before his cold? He sends out his words and melts them. He makes his wind blow and the waters flow. He declares his word to Jacob, his statutes and rules to Israel. He has not dealt thus with any other nation. They do not know his rule. Praise the Lord. So God, searcher of all our hearts, you have formed us as a people and claimed us for your own. As we come to acknowledge your sovereign grace and to enter anew into covenant with you, reveal any reluctance or falsehoods within us. Let your spirit impress your truth on your inmost being and receive us in mercy. For the sake of our mediator, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. So I'm going to read, and yes, you've got a handout. Your response will be in bold. So to the Father who has given us every spiritual blessing in Christ, and they said, we give praise and glory to the Son through whom we have redemption, forgiveness, and riches of God's grace. We give praise and glory to the Spirit that seals us in his promise, the guarantee of our inheritance until we possess it. We give praise and glory. This is a prayer of confession that I'd like to read. Friends, as we gather our thoughts into quietness, we confess our sins to the one who knows us best. We know ourselves chosen, adopted as children of God. We dare to believe that you and I are part of a plan conceived for the foundation of the universe. But are we living as God's children? Are we honoring our inheritance? We know ourselves called, but we're so easily distracted. We know ourselves loved, but we walk at the cost. Come, friends, let us confess our sins to the Lord. Friends, talks about the Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So we're going to go through the verses and then try to dissect a little bit about that. So Ephesians 1, verses 3 through 14. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly place. Even as we chose us in Him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and blameless before Him. In love, He predestines us for adoption to Himself as sons through Jesus Christ, according to the purpose of His will, to the praise of His glorious grace, with which He has blessed us in the beloved. In Him we have redemption through His blood, and forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of His grace, which He lavished upon us in all wisdom and insight, made known to us the mystery of His will, according to His purpose, which He set forth in Christ, as a plan for fullness of time to unite all things in Him, things in heaven and things on earth. In Him we have obtained an inheritance, having been predestined according to the purpose of Him who works all things according to the counsel of His will, so that we, who were the first to hope in Christ, might be to the praise of His glory. In Him you also, when you heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and believed in Him, were sealed with the promised Holy Spirit, who is the guarantee of your inheritance until we acquire possession of it to the praise of His glory. This text is totally God-centered, God-directed, and inspired. This should reflect on how our lives should be in 2021. They should be God-centered, God-directed, and God-inspired. Let's look back over the previous year, 2020, how can we ever forget it? You know, we had some dark times, but God was with us. Ask the Holy Spirit what you're supposed to be doing, where you should be. Who or what did He turn to during this past year of 2020? Did you turn to social media? Some of us may have turned to drugs and alcohol. Can we turn to friends, co-workers, and family? Do we turn to politics or pornography? What did you turn to? Ask the Holy Spirit what you're supposed to be doing. Reach out to Him as He knows best. He is the one person to turn to. Look at the amazing things that had happened in 2020. I'm sure there was new grandparents. People gave birth, had new children. God's hands were totally involved in this. We have another day. We're in 2021 now. We have family. We have each other. Jesus Christ is our Father. If we look at Revelation 21:5, it says, He who was seated at the throne said, Behold, I am making all things new. Also he said, Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true. And he said to me, It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, in the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give from the springs of water of life without payment, and one who conquers will have this heritage, and I will be his God, and he will be my son. We know that God is always at work. We do not know his plan, but he is always at work, and he is always there for us. If you look at 1 Chronicles, it's understood that there are times and seasons of how God builds his kingdom. So we still see today God working inside of time to advance His purposes. He is the Creator. In Genesis, it explains the creation of the universe and concludes with His creation of a new heaven and a new earth. In this scripture, I'd like to point out 3 points. The first point is God the Father plans salvation. The second point is God the Son purchases salvation. And the third point is God the Spirit applies and seals salvation. So to the first part, God the Father plans salvation. In verse 4, you look at, even as He chose Him, or chose God gives us graciously and freely salvation. We are holy and blameless in his sight. God shows us, and when we belong to him through Jesus Christ, he looks at us as we have never sinned. Look at verse 5. He predestined us. Predestined means we're marked out beforehand. This means that God picked your name through the sacrifice of his Son. He has brought us into his family. He is our family. Have you adopted this loving relationship with God? The second point, God's Son purchases salvation. It says, in him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of his grace. The blood was the first century way of speaking to Christ's death. So in verse 7, his death speaks of two wonderful truths that we can cherish. It talks about redemption and forgiveness. Redemption was Christ paid to gain freedom for a slave. Forgiveness in the Old Testament times was the basis for shedding the blood of animals. Now that Jesus has died for our sins and shed his blood, we are now forgiven. Jesus died as the perfect and final sacrifice. In verses 9 through 10, salvation is not a secret, and God does not want to keep it from us. God's plan could not be imagined until Christ rose from the dead to forgive our sins. God's plan is to bring us all together and unite us as one church and one family. In him, we will bow down to him, whether it is for his love or because we fear his power. He will bring us together to be with him forever. In verse 11, God's purpose is to offer salvation to everyone. God is sovereign. God is in charge. When life is chaotic, and boy, has it been chaotic this past year, believe in the truth. Jesus is Lord, and God is in control. Without God's grace, no one can be saved. We receive this through our faith in Jesus Christ. The third point is God's Spirit applies and seals salvation. In verse 13, it says, in him you also, when you heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and believed in him, were sealed with the promise of the Holy Spirit. So Paul here, God has placed a seal upon us as well. It is to guarantee that we are genuine. It shows ownership. Who we belong to, it shows we are approved, and it provides us protection and security. When we are with God, our sins are forgiven. Our futures are secure. We will be like Christ. We will be made perfect like him. So looking ahead to 2021, God will be there as well. He is here now. He is with us. He is with us this morning. Will you forgive others?